So dear students, previous class we have come across narrow utilitarian of ecosystem. Under narrow utilitarian you have come across 5 points: food, second is drugs and medicine, third is fuel, fourth is fibers, fifth is industrial product. Followed by that, today look over broadly utilitarian means unlimited services provided by the ecosystem. Unlimited services provided by the ecosystem. Under that, one is oxygen, second is pollination, third you are going to study aesthetic value. First is oxygen. More than 20% of the oxygen on the earth is provided by the tropical forest of Amazon. More than 20% of the earth oxygen is provided by the forest of Amazon. Amazonian rainforest, previous class we have come across, is commonly called as lungs of planet, because alone will contribute more than 20% of the oxygen present on the earth. Second is pollination. Back to chapter number 2, sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Move to second chapter, sexual reproduction in flowering plant, where I come across this word pollination. Transfer of pollen from anther to the stigma, transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of either the same flower or a different flower is called as pollination. Pollination will take place by different agencies. Pollination will take place by different agencies. Without pollination, plants cannot produce fruits and seeds. Transfer of pollen from anther to the stigma of either the same flower or a different flower is called as pollination. Without pollination, plants cannot produce fruits and seeds. You know already, pollination will take place by different agencies. Under that, few examples which I come across is entomophily, where the pollination will take place by the agency of insects. Anemophily, pollination takes place by the agency of wind. Zoophily, pollination will take place by animals. Hydrophily, pollination will take place by water. If suppose human beings are involved in the process of pollination, the estimated cost is $117 billion. If suppose human beings are involved in the process of pollination, the estimated cost is $117 billion. So this sun chart which gives the idea where the pollination will take place by different agencies. So this sun chart which gives the idea of pollination will take place by different agencies. Next is aesthetic values. So due to their beauty, many birds, mammals, butterflies, forest have great aesthetic value to the human beings. Due to their beauty, many birds, mammals, butterflies and forest have a great aesthetic value to the human beings. Aesthetic pleasure derived from the biodiversity includes watching birds, mammals, butterflies, walking through the woods, gardening, pet keeping, etc. Okay, the aesthetic pleasure derived from the biodiversity includes watching color butterflies, birds, flowers, mammals, waking up even due to bulbul's song, waking up due to bulbul's song early in the morning, walking through the woods, etc. is having a great pleasure to the human beings. So you know already, our planet is shared by millions of, our planet is shared by millions of plants, animals, microorganisms. All they will directly or indirectly will play a significant role in the nature. Our planet is shared by millions of plants, animals, and microorganisms or microbes. Directly or indirectly, they will play a significant role in the nature. As a result, it is your moral duty, to support biodiversity, or it is moral duty of the human beings to conserve biodiversity. Next matter is conservation. Now look over conservation. So it is the scientific management. Conservation is the scientific management, preservation and restoration of biodiversity. Conservation is the scientific management, preservation and restoration of biodiversity. You know already, biodiversity is a collection of varieties of all forms of life. Conservation is the scientific management where they are going to preserve and restore and maintain the methods in a very scientific way. It is the scientific management, preservation and restoration of biodiversity. Conservation are broadly classified into two groups, or it includes two types: in situ conservation and ex situ conservation. In situ conservation and ex situ conservation. In situ conservation, it involves conserving the plants and animals, are protecting the plants and animals in their natural habitat. In situ includes conservation of the plants and animals in the natural habitat. In situ conservation is the conservation of the plants and animals in the natural habitat. Here they will give protection to either single species or group of species, or sometimes biodiversity rich regions are identified, then it is protected legally. Conservation are of two types, in situ conservation and ex situ conservation. Conservation of the plants and animals in the natural habitat is called as in situ conservation. In in situ conservation, they will give protection or they will conserve either single species or sometimes a group of species or biodiversity rich regions are identified. Biodiversity rich regions are identified, then it is protected legally. Under that you are going to study hot spot. Many more examples are also there, including national park, sanctuaries, but you are going to study only hot spots. Ex situ conservation. Conservation of the plants and animals in man-made environment is called as ex situ conservation. Conservation of plants and animals in man-made environment is called as ex situ conservation. It includes zoological gardens, botanical gardens, seed banks, cryopreservation, tissue culture, etc. Conservation of the plants and animals in man-made environment is called as ex situ conservation. It includes botanical gardens, zoological gardens, seed banks, cryopreservation, tissue culture. But you are going to study only seed bank and cryopreservation in detail, and I would like to introduce even tissue culture indirectly. Now look over seed bank. So zoological garden and botanical garden is no more related. Directly I will enter into seed bank. In seed bank, look over the name carefully, will get an idea. In seed banks, seeds of endangered species are kept dormant. Are kept dormant in 5 to 10% humidity and 20 degrees centigrade temperature. In the seed bank, seeds of endangered species. Endangered means which are in danger of becoming extinct. In seed bank, seeds of endangered species. Endangered means which are in danger of becoming extinct are stored in 5 to 10% of humidity and 20 degrees centigrade temperature. 5 to 10% of humidity and 20 degrees centigrade temperature. Next matter is cryopreservation. In cryopreservation, cells of embryo, cells of embryo and shoot tip cells, shoot tip cells are stored in liquid nitrogen, are stored in liquid nitrogen at minus 196 degree centigrade temperature. Look over here. In cryopreservation, cells of embryo, you know already meaning of cell and meaning of embryo. Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Embryo is nothing but multicellular zygote. Embryo is nothing but multicellular zygote. Cells of embryo and shoot tip cells. Shoot tip is nothing but meristems. Shoot tip is nothing but meristematic tissues. You know already they are present in the growing regions of the plant body. Meristematic tissue is having one unique character. Meristos means to divide. They are all actively metabolizing cells. They are all actively metabolizing and dividing cells. So cells of embryo and shoot tip cells are stored in liquid nitrogen at minus 196 degrees centigrade. So in cryopreservation, cells of the embryo and shoot tip cells are stored in liquid nitrogen at minus 196 degrees centigrade temperature. Minus 196 degrees centigrade temperature. So last point is tissue culture. Students, here definition of tissue culture is not required. So under extra information, I am providing definition of tissue culture. Tissue culture is a technique in which the tissues of plants or animal origin are isolated and are grown in an artificially prepared nutrient media under aseptic and under controlled condition. Tissue culture is a technique in which the tissues of plants or animal origin, Plants of commercial value are propagated by tissue culture technique. Plants having commercial values are propagated by tissue culture technique. Even interesting point, gametes of threatened species, you know already. So in human reproduction, I come across this word gamete, and even in my first chapter also, I come across this word gamete. Gametes are highly specialized haploid sexual cells, which take direct part in the process of fertilization. Gametes of threatened species. Threatened means whose number is decreasing and likely to decrease more in the near future. Gametes of threatened species can be stored for a longer period by this technique. Gametes are highly specialized haploid sexual cells, which take direct part in the process of fertilization. Threatened means whose number is decreasing and likely to decrease more in the near future, are stored and kept fertile for a longer period by cryopreservation. Please remember, plants of commercial value are propagated by tissue culture technique. So that ends ex-situ conservation. Under that, I quoted 5 examples, but for the point of examination, you have to remember only seed banks, cryopreservation, and tissue culture. Next is hot spot. Hot spot is the region which is having 1500 hotspot is the region which is having 1500 vascular plants as an endemic, and it has lost around 70% of its native habitat. Hotspot is the region which is having 1500 vascular plants as an endemic. Endemic means they are found only in the specific geographical regions. Hotspot is the region which is having at least 1500 vascular plants as an endemic, and it has lost around 70% of its natural habitat. 1500 vascular plants. Vascular means the plants which possess xylem and phloem. You know, xylem is a water conducting tissue, phloem is a food conducting tissue. Endemic means they are found only in this specific geographical area, and it has lost around 70% of its natural habitat. So for CET purpose or NEET examination purpose, please remember this point. So according to recent report, there are 3 hotspots, 14 biosphere reserves, 90 national park and 448 wildlife sanctuaries have been identified in India. According to recent report, India is having 3 hotspots. India is having 3 hotspots, 14 biosphere reserves, 90 national park, 448 wildlife sanctuaries. So 3 hotspots which are found in India are northwestern and eastern Himalaya, northwestern and eastern Himalayas, Western Ghats and Sri Lanka, Indo-Burma and Himalaya. Dear students, please take care of these numbers. According to recent reports, so there are about 3 hotspots are there in India, 14 biosphere reserves, 90 national park, 448 wildlife sanctuaries. So 3 hotspots which are found in India are northwestern and eastern Himalayas, Western Ghats and Sri Lanka, Indo-Burma and Himalaya. Next matter you have to take care, and please remember for NEET purpose, total 34 biodiversity hotspots are there all over the world. Especially they are located in the tropical forest. Please remember, there are about 30 biodiversity hotspots have been identified. Especially they are located in the tropical forest or tropical regions. Next matter is sacred groves. Now look over, dear students, sacred groves. These are traditionally conserved patches of forest. Dedicated to local deity. Sacred groves are the traditionally conserved patches of forest dedicated to local deity. And many examples are there, and you have to remember few examples what I have quoted here. Kashi and Jaintia Hills in Meghalaya. Kashi and Jaintia Hills in Meghalaya. Aravali Hills of Rajasthan. Western Ghat regions of Karnataka and Maharashtra. Sarguja, Chanda and Bastar area of MP. So dear students, please remember, sacred groves are traditionally conserved patches of forest dedicated to local deity, where they will give protection to a wide variety of organisms, and this sacred groves are considered as an god's first temple. You have to take care this matter related to CET purpose. Kashi and Jaintia Hills in Meghalaya, Aravali Hills of Rajasthan, Western Ghat regions of Karnataka and Maharashtra, Sarguja, Chanda, Basrat area of Madhya Pradesh or MP. And please remember, Meghalaya is the last refuges for the rare and threatened plants. It is the last sacred groves. Meghalaya is the last sacred groves for the rare and threatened plants. Rare, you know, threatened means whose number is decreasing and likely to decrease more in the near future. Decreasing and likely to decrease more in the near future. Now, last point related to biodiversity and conservation. Please take care of these two points, because when you open or when you go through the previous paper, based on these two points, they have arisen questions. Look, our dear students, last matter, international efforts for conserving biodiversity. International efforts for conserving biodiversity. The historic convention on biodiversity, the historic convention on biodiversity held in Rio de Janeiro. Held in Rio de Janeiro in 1992, international efforts for conserving biodiversity. The historic convention on biodiversity held in Rio de Janeiro in the year 1992 called upon all the nations to take an appropriate measure for the conservation of biodiversity and the sustainable utilization of biodiversity. Look over, dear students, international efforts for conserving biodiversity. The historic convention on biodiversity, the historic convention on biodiversity held in Rio de Janeiro in the year 1992. called upon all the nations to take appropriate measure for the conservation of biodiversity and the sustainable utilization of biodiversity. Sustainable utilization of biodiversity. World Summit on Sustainable Development, World Summit on Sustainable Development was held in 2002 in Johannesburg, South Africa, around 190 countries have promised to reduce the present rate of biodiversity loss. Korea World Summit on Sustainable Development was held in 2002, Johannesburg, South Africa. World Summit on Sustainable Development was held in 2002, Johannesburg, South Africa. Or it took place in Johannesburg, South Africa. Around 190 countries have promised to reduce the present rate of loss of biodiversities. So that ends international efforts for conserving biodiversity. Dear students, in KCET 2020, no questions have appeared from the biodiversity and conservation. But in NEET 2020, only two questions have appeared. That I will write and I will explain. Look over 2020, two questions have appeared from the biodiversity and conservation. Number one, according to Robert May, the global species diversity is about, you know, it is 7 million. Very easy question. According to Robert May, the global species diversity is about 7 million. Okay, it is 7 million. Second, which of the following regions of the globe which of the following regions of the globe exhibit highest species diversity? You know, indirect level provided clue. It is commonly called as lungs of planet. No doubt, it is Amazon forest. Okay, lungs of planet, because alone will contribute more than 20% of the oxygen present in the earth. Okay, answer is Amazon forest. So that ends biodiversity and conservation. So dear students, one or two questions commonly noticed in the NEET examination. So therefore, don't omit the chapter. Okay.